Okay, so what we're having a look at here is a differential equation. Now, we have used differential equations in 2-unit before. If you think back to exponential growth and decay, there's an equation that relates the derivative of an equation a particular variable, something like this, dp on dt. So there's population, there's time. And the change in the population with respect to time, the rate of change of the population, is proportional to the population. So that's a differential equation. It relates a function to its derivative. That's something we got from 2 units, so the exponential function, like a e to the kt. If you chuck that into there, differentiate it with respect to time, then you will get back just a constant coefficient out the front of your original function. That's in 2-unit. In extension 1, you might be more familiar with things like x equaling negative n squared x double dot, sorry. So we've got acceleration in terms of displacement here. So that's a derivative with respect to time in terms of the original function. This is not exponential growth and decay. This is simple harmonic motion. So it's going back and forth and back and forth. So we've met differential equations before, even if you haven't called them that. But this particular differential equation here, in order to handle it, we need to work with a little tiny strategy that's very useful, which is actually from mathematics extension 2. So I'll unpack that, but there's quite a few different discrete steps here that will help us do this, and so I'm going to break it down as much as I can. So the first thing is we need to understand what the question is asking. It says find the general solution. So what's that saying is there is some function that is generally true, but there's different versions of it. Now, as you can see, because we have a derivative here, I am going to integrate, and when they say general solution, they're basically saying, you know what, you're gonna get a constant in that, no big deal, just leave it there. Finding the constant would give us the particular solution, but they're kind of like, look, we don't mind which one it is, we just want the family of functions that are the general solution to this particular differential equation. So that's the first thing that they're asking for, a little bit different, though related to the general solution of a trigonometric equation. We're thinking calculus here. And then you get given this, we'll unpack that in a minute, that's gonna be the bulk of our time. But then there's this guy, just to finish. When we get our solution, they want it with y as the subject and have that as a function of x. Now, that will take an extra few steps because what you've got here is everything is as a function of y, not as a function of x. So what we're going to have to do in the end is we're going to have to transpose everything so it's in terms of x's instead of in terms of y's, which is where we begin, okay? Now, the very first thing I'm going to start off with, when I have a look at this, I have a derivative with respect to x, and then I have a function in terms of y. They don't play very well together. I want everything to be talking in terms of the same variable. So what I'm going to do is a simple trick that you might remember from when you did rates of change, related rates of change back in 2-unit. We write this, we write the derivative as a fraction. We don't just write it as like f dash, for instance, or, y dot. We also write it as a fraction because in many regards, not all of them, but in many regards, you can treat the derivative just like a fraction, and you can do all the same things with fractions that you can do with derivatives, like multiply things and they cancel, or importantly in this case, take reciprocals. That's what we're going to do to get toward a better solution. So if I take the reciprocal of the left-hand side, instead of getting dx, dy on dx, I have dx on dy. Over on the right-hand side, I get this. Now, the reason why this is immediately better is because now I can integrate both sides with respect to y, because I've got a dy here, and this is a function in terms of y. So I'm going to do exactly that. Now, if I integrate with respect to y, I'm just going to get left with the x on the left-hand side, right? Now, that's not quite what I want. I want y as a function of x, not x as a function of y, but I will get to that later on. I get left with this x, and I've got this integral now of this guy, 2y, 1 minus 5y, and this is with respect to y. So there's my integral, okay? Now at this point, we look and we think, what next? And this is where the extension 2 strategy comes in, but you may have encountered this already. I have a fraction here that needs to be separated out, broken into pieces that I can deal with independently. Because this guy, I don't have any formula in my head that magically gives me that. It's not sine inverse or tan inverse or something like that. Even though there are some y squareds, it's a bit more messy and I can't just simply use reverse chain rule. It's not like something all to a power. So I want to break this apart, this one fraction, I want to break it into two. And the name of the little strategy that we're going to use, I'm going to move over here for a second and come back to that. It's called partial fractions because, as the name suggests, we're going to break this fraction into parts, okay? Now, to illustrate what this looks like in case some people have never met it before, if I ask you to add two fractions together, like this, okay? We've been dealing with these fractions since year 7, so we know what to do. We want a common denominator, and so what we would say is, well, the easiest way to get a common denominator is to multiply each denominator by the other one, right? So for example, I would multiply this guy by 5 on 5, which would give me this, and then I would multiply this guy by 4 on 4, which would give me this. And hey presto, now our two fractions are talking the same language and I can combine them. I don't need to know the answer to this to illustrate how I can use this for something like so, right? If I had two different things, like say 3 on x plus 1 on y, right? By the same principle, I would be multiplying each of these together, multiplying each of the denominators by the opposite denominator so I can have them talking the same language, right? So I would get, presumably, 3y on xy and x on xy. Now they're both on xy and I can just combine these, okay? Well, if instead of x and y, I wanted these two pieces, then I know, you know, this is like one whole big fraction now, 3y plus x on xy. This whole big fraction, it came from two separate fractions that had these pieces as the denominators. And all I need is to, I need to factorize it, which conveniently has already been done for me, right? So what I'm going to suggest, which will be helpful for my integral over here, this is all just rough working, let's put this aside, is I'm going to suggest let's express this in terms of two fractions, and I'm going to use this little trick here. So I'm going to say let my original fraction over here, 1 minus 5y, let it be equal to two different fractions, a on one part and b on the other, where a and b, they're just some numbers, which I'm going to find out. They're some constants, and if I get the right A and the right B, then all the terms will cancel out when I combine these two together to get the original fraction, the one that I actually want, okay? So to see what exact value of A and what exact value of B I need, I'm gonna do what I did before and combine these two fractions into one, because that's what they're supposed to be equal to. I'll multiply across, so that gives me this, 1 minus 5y lots of that, and that looks like just 2by over there. And now that I've combined these into one, I've collapsed their two denominators into one denominator, okay? Now, just one line here to expand this out a little bit. So this is an a times 1, and then I've got minus 5ay plus 2by. Okay, now, even though I don't need to because it hasn't changed, I'm gonna rewrite this left-hand side over here, because what it allows me to do is a comparison from the left-hand side to the right-hand side. Denominators are the same, therefore, the numerators also ought to be the same, but pay close attention. You can see that, need another color. You can see that some of these terms have y's in them and some of them are just constants, right? So these guys here, these have y's in them, whereas this one here is just a constant. Now, just like in, you know, when we did auxiliary angle in mathematics extension 1, for those of you who remember that, I can do a comparison of coefficients over here. I can look at the constant terms. Here's a constant. There's no y's attached to that. And then I can look at the y terms that compare. Now, it just so happens on this side, there are no y terms. Like, there they are. How many y's are there? Answer, none of them. I could even write, you know, plus 0y. So now I can do my comparison. I can say, on this basis, A must be 1, because there's no other spot for the constant to come from on both sides. And this guy here, and minus 5a plus 2b, those are all y bits, but there are no y bits. So this should equal 0. Now, I already worked out what A is, so that's negative 5 plus 2B equals 0. If I rearrange this guy, 2B equals 5, B equals 5 on 2. Okay. So now I have an A and a B, and what were those? They are the things that go on top of these fractions. Now watch how this actually works for us, right? I did all of that just so that this fraction over here, I can break it into two pieces. Two pieces I can actually integrate, because look at what they look like now. Instead of this weird, awkward fraction, right, what have I got? Let's see, I've got one big bracket, 1 on 2y, there's the A that I just got from there. Plus, what have I got? 5 on 2. 5 on 2 on the top of 1 minus 5y. Now, this looks longer and more awkward. It is certainly longer, but it's not less awkward because both of these guys I can integrate. They're both just going to become logs. I can totally deal with these guys. So it will still take a bit of work, but you can see the trajectory I'm headed on now. We'll get a bit more space so we can continue going.